Hi, I'm Cathy with LevelUpRN. In this video, I will be going through several examples of converting within the household system using two different methods, which include dimensional analysis and ratio and proportion. You can find all the information that I'll be covering in this video in our LevelUpRN dosage calculation workbook. If you are in nursing school, then you know how important it is to master dosage calculations, and our workbook will help you do just that. For more information about our workbook, you can click here, but in a nutshell, our workbook contains all different types of dosage calculation problems that you are likely to encounter in nursing school, and we demonstrate how to solve each problem using multiple methods so you can pick the way that makes the most sense to you. All right, in this video, I am going to work through a number of example problems that involve converting within the household system. And in order to be able to do these problems, you have to memorize these conversion factors over here on the side of my whiteboard. So definitely remember that 1 pound equals 16 ounces, 1 tablespoon equals 3 teaspoons, 1 cup equals 8 fluid ounces, 1 pint equals 2 cups, 1 quart equals 2 pints, 1 gallon equals 4 quarts, and 1 foot equals 12 inches. So we are gonna solve these example problems using dimensional analysis and ratio and proportion. And some of you may be like, I can do some of this in my head, and that's great, but it's good to get familiar with these methods when the problems are really easy so that you know how to use those methods when the problems get harder. Okay, so let's first solve this first example problem, which asks us to convert 2.4 pounds into ounces using dimensional analysis. So 2.4 pounds, we write down the current units of measure, so that's 2.4 pounds, and then we're gonna multiply it times the appropriate conversion factor, which is this first one here. So we're gonna set it up so that 16 ounces is on top and 1 pound is on bottom. So that way my pounds will cross off and I'll be left with ounces. So if you multiply this out, you end up with 38.4 ounces, okay? Let's solve it now with ratio and proportion. So we're gonna put our known ratio down first. So 1 pound equals 16 ounces. And we wanna know for 2.4 pounds, how many ounces is that? So the X is our unknown value. And I could have set this ratio up kind of flipped. So I could have said 16 ounces over 1 pound equals X ounces over 2.4 pounds. That would be fine too. That's the benefit of ratio and proportion, is that you have that flexibility. With dimensional analysis, things have to be set up just so in order for it to be correct. So now we are going to do our cross multiplication. So X times 1 is just X, and then we have 16 times 2.4. And if we multiply this out, we end up with the same answer, which is 38.4 ounces. Let's work through another example of converting within the household system. So we're gonna do it using dimensional analysis and then ratio and proportion. So with this example problem, we wanna convert 9 teaspoons into tablespoons. So we're gonna write down the current units of measure, which is 9 teaspoons, multiply it times the appropriate conversion factor, which is gonna be right here, right? 1 tablespoon equals 3 teaspoons. So I wanna put my tablespoons on top because that's what I'm looking for, and my teaspoons on bottom so that my units will cross off here. And then if I multiply this out, I end up with 3 tablespoons, okay? You might've been able to do that in your head, and that's cool. We're just working through it using these methods so you can get used to the methods. Okay, let's do this with ratio and proportion. So we know that 1 tablespoon equals 3 teaspoons, and we wanna know how many tablespoons are in 9 teaspoons, okay? So X is our unknown value. So now we're going to cross multiply here. So 9 times 1 is 9, and 3 times X is 3X. And then we're just going to solve for X. So X equals 9 divided by 3, and X equals 3. So we have 3 tablespoons here as well. Get the same answer. All right, let's go through our third example problem of converting within the household system. With this problem, we want to convert 5 foot 2 inches into just inches. So we're actually going to do this kind of in two steps. So we first want to convert this 5 feet into inches. So we're going to solve this with dimensional analysis as well as ratio and proportion. So using dimensional analysis, we want to write down what we currently have, what our current units of measure are, which is 5 feet. And then we're going to multiply times the appropriate conversion factor in order to get to inches. So this is the one we're going to use down here. So we have 12 inches is in 1 foot. So I write it like this so that my feet will cross off and I am left with 60 inches. So that's how many inches are in 5 feet, but I also need to add in this other 2 inches. So 60 inches plus the 2 additional inches equals 62 inches. And that little symbol there is the same thing as inches. All right, let's solve this same problem using ratio and proportion. So let's first write down the known ratio, the thing that we know to be true, 12 inches equals 1 foot. So that is the known ratio. And then on this side, we want to know how many inches are in 5 feet. And we're going to cross multiply here. So 1 times X is just X. And then we have 12 times 5. And that equals 60. So again, that's how many inches are in 5 feet. But we are being asked how many inches are in 5 feet 2 inches. So we need to add that additional 2 inches to get 62 inches. And that's how you would solve that problem using dimensional analysis and ratio and proportion.
We invite you to subscribe to our channel and share a link with your classmates and friends in nursing school. And if you found value in this video, be sure to hit that like button and let us know what you found to be particularly helpful.